In this section, we'll be covering the effects tab. And basically, this will allow you to apply effects to text or shapes, whatever design you have, in an instant. So I'm going to start off with this simple circular shape here. And what I'm going to do is head on down underneath the layers tab. There's something called layer effects. I'm going to click on that and you see this pop-up box has appeared. And there's many different options here, but we'll start off with a simple one that's probably used quite often, and that is outer shadow. So I could just go ahead and click on that, and you see it's applied a shadow to it. And we've got all these options that relate to it. So I can play around with the opacity of this. I can click on the radius. You see it blurs it a little bit, so we'll keep it kind of midway. And I can click on offset as well. So if I click on offset, it basically drags it inwards, and so it's kind of directly behind. If I drag it this way, it's like there's a light source on the top left and it's shining down and casting this shadow. I can also change the direction of that said light source by playing around with angle down here. So I can just click on that and I can change the direction of it. Alternatively, if you're more hands-on, you can click on the offset tool, just click on that, and then you can actually grab that shadow and play around with it yourself. And of course you can change the color of the shadow, but I'm just going to leave it as it is for now. And also the intensity, which I think I've just shown you, but there we go, there's intensity. So that's one effect. So one important thing I want to show you is this thing here, scale with object. By default, it's usually off. So let's just leave it as it is and we'll press close. Now, if I scale this object down, you'll see that the effect is looking completely different. So if you're designing something small, and let's say you want to make it bigger, you want the effect to remain the same. So what I can do, head on over to my layers tab, and you see on the layer that I have the effect applied to, it now has an FX icon. I can just click on that and the pop-up box reappears. So now let's try clicking on scale with object, and I'll press close. We'll try again. So as I scale down, you can see it's exactly the same as it was when it was at its big size. Okay, great. Okay, one last thing on this. Actually, I can overlay it, and there's a shape underneath, and I can go back into the effects tab again, and you can play around with the blend mode. This blend mode will affect whichever effect you've got. So I've got a shadow here. I can click on multiply and go down to average, let's say, click on that, and you'll see it changes based on the layer underneath. But for now, I'll just place it on normal. Okay, and I'll press close. Another really important thing, especially that will save you time, is the ability to be able to duplicate this effect onto different layers. So in the layers tab, we have this purple circle, and then we've got this triangle underneath this blue one. If I want to copy the effect from this to this, I simply go over to the layers tab, click on that FX icon, click and drag it down and let go. And now you can see it's applied it to the triangle shape. Okay, let's apply a layer effect to this text here. The text is still typable, by the way. I have it selected. I'm going to click on layer effects and the pop-up box will appear. I'll just resize this so you see what's going to happen here. I'm not going to show you all of the inner shadow, inner glow, outer glow, because they handle the same way as the outer shadow. So what I'm going to do here is just show you bevel and emboss. And you see when I click on it, it's already showing me the result, but there's four different types. So there's pillow, there's emboss, there's outer, and there's also inner as well. So let's have a play around with some of these settings. I'll just zoom in a little bit so you can see better. So we can play around with the radius, and you can kind of see what's happening here. And also I can soften this. And also I can change the direction of the light. So it says inner, it's kind of like these letters are sunk into something. So I can drag this down further, so I can see more of the shadow. So imagine the sun's coming from this way and it's creating these shadows, and then the highlights are affecting this part here. I can bring down the radius more to change the effect of it and bring down the softness too. So you can have a good play around with that. Also, if you didn't like the highlight color or the shadow color, you can go ahead and click on these. And remember, there's blend modes applied as well. So if you didn't want a black one, you could have, let's say, a purple one. But right now it's not really showing, is it? It's because the blend mode is on multiply. If I just chucked it on normal, you'd start to see it. And I'll bring it out slightly more. And you can see this purple start coming through a little bit. And you can play around with it until you get the effect that you want. I'm just going to go back a couple of steps, Command-Z, and there we go, back to around about here. And I want to show you there's profiles. These are pressure profiles, and there's a few presets here. So if I clicked on that one, it would make it look more like it has a bevel. And if I click on this one, you can kind of see what's going on. If you look at the letters, it kind of, it's flat and then it curves up and then it curves around. And this is this shape here, isn't it? And you could just cycle through those, whichever one you'd like, or you can actually play around with them yourself to make those changes. So that's bevel and emboss. And of course you have other ones as well, like you can combine these two. So you have outline here. Let's say we wanted to add an outline onto this. I can click on that and I could bring up the radius and I can change the color of it as well. Maybe something like that, maybe a bit lighter. And I can align it to the inside, the center, the outside, anything you want here. And then the fill style, is it solid color? Is it a contour? Is it a gradient? You decide. So you can get creative and combine all of them. If you no longer want any of them, you just simply uncheck them and you just press close and you're back to normal again. Okay, now I just want to show you how you can create a kind of bowl effect. And I made a tutorial on this like years ago, but I'll just choose some kind of blue color like that. And I'll go down to layer effects. And this time we'll click on 3D. And I'll bring the radius up like this, and you can see it's starting to look three-dimensional. But the important thing here is the pressure profile. So if I click on that, I'll choose one of these to begin with. Yeah, I'll choose this one here as a starting point, just like that last example I showed you. And then I can start playing around with the look of it. So let's say we want... yeah, we want this bit to be kind of flat down there, and we want this to come up like this. And you can see this is kind of like looking at a plate from above or a bowl, and you can go ahead and change the direction of the light here. You can get really creative and start adding in your own little nodes in here. Have a good play around with this. All of these other options here, like diffuse, etc., it's all about lighting, like specular shininess. So get creative and don't set limits for yourself. Okay, so that's the layer effects. Let's move on.